Hello and welcome back to the Vector Technology Days 2019. I'm Thomas Wieland and I have some exclusive interviews for you here on the Vector YouTube channel. For many years, hardware was one of the only things automotive developers have to really think about, but that changed within the last few years. Software is becoming more and more important, and more devices are being equipped with highly complex software. Practical devices like vacuum cleaning robots or life-saving devices such as defibrillators. And that makes software development more and more difficult. Ingo Niklas is with me and he's Senior Field Application Engineer for VectorCast. Ingo, thanks for being here. And first question is, what are the challenges software development is currently struggling with?
Yes, what we see at the moment is that software is getting more and more complex. More and more features are going from hardware into software, as you already mentioned. So the testing becomes more complex because there's more software to test, of course. Also, we see that software is taking more responsibilities. That means there is a higher need for a good software quality because software is responsible. For example, if you think about autonomous driving, if the software takes control over the car and over the people in the car and over life, then it's important that the software works the way it is designed.
So you said it's all about software quality. So how can VectorCast help to increase this software quality?
Well, we are in the business of software testing for about 30 years now. We started in Avionic and their software quality was from the beginning a very important thing. We can help with the testing process as it is recommended by the software standards like DO178 in Avionic or ISO 26262 in automotive. And we can help with unit testing, we can help with integration level testing, and we can help with code coverage measurement.
So you said continuous testing, and it's a term I hear and read everywhere. What makes VectorCast different in this case from other tools?
We have a workflow that we developed together with our customers where we try to identify what are the needs and how can we implement a continuous testing environment. For example, we have integrations into continuous integration tools like Jenkins or Bamboo. And what we can do is we have test cases that can be re-executed change-based. That means we can look at when source code changes, we can detect which test case is affected by the source code change, which test environment needs to rebuild. So we can rerun all the affected test cases, we can parallelize the execution of the test cases, and we support this change-based test case execution.
Thank you, Ingo, for this exclusive insight into VectorCast. And here we are at the Vector Technology Days 2019. We did a lot of interviews for you, and you can all find them on the Vector YouTube channel. Just scroll through and find more about vVirtual Target, cybersecurity for ECU hardware, or the integration of AUTOSAR and Android. And there's more to come, so see you later.